G'day Bambies, Collider here, and today we are building another house in The Sims 4, and this is going to be a two-parter because this is a giant build and it is for my new series, Goddess. So that's going to be coming out hopefully in a couple days, which I am working on right now. But yeah, I really wanted to share with you guys in the meantime this build, which I did especially for it. And I know a lot of you guys have already been a part of the creation of previous houses which I've made for this series. But because I am relaunching it with a totally new storyline, I wanted to make something brand new and something that would actually match that storyline, because unfortunately the previous house did not match at all. But yeah, anyways, I did try to do something totally different to before. There are some little aspects to it that kind of nod to the previous houses, but in many other ways, it is its own build. I was very much inspired by houses in the Greek Isles, especially if you're looking from either this angle or the angle that has the pool that's like submerged into a basement. But yeah, so this actually took me 8 hours plus all up to create. So that is why we're doing it in two parts, guys. I did try to squeeze it all into one video and it was just impossible to watch. So I didn't want to do that to you guys. It was way too crazy and I don't want to give you guys a headache. So I hope you guys don't mind me putting this into two parts. And there are going to be a couple cuts here and there, but it's just how we have to do it. Unfortunately, I was just very, very much a perfectionist during this build because, you know, Goddess is my baby. It's one of my favorite stories that I've ever created in The Sims 4. It's definitely my baby. It's something very precious to me. So while I was creating this place, it did take me a lot longer than normal buildings because I just really wanted to get it correct, and I did have a lot of trouble with roofing, actually. I have to be honest, guys. But yeah, anyways, we're already 3 minutes in, and I haven't told you guys the name of it. You've probably already seen it in the title. So this is a abandoned beauty. So I'm going to give you guys a bit of a hint of what it looked like in its prime days. I do try out with some of these bright blue windows at the beginning, and the roof color does change quite a lot. But eventually I do change the blue window frames to a faded blue to kind of give it an aspect that it has aged. No one has been painting this place. And yeah, and also you can tell that the walls right now are a very smooth stone, and later on I change it to kind of like a dilapidated, kind of crumbling looking brick that sort of has white paint on top of it, but you can kind of see the brick underneath because no one has been maintaining the paint. And over the years, it's starting to fall away. I was really inspired by a bunch of awesome photos that I found online in the Greek Isles, and the back of this build, especially with the pool and with the little arches underground there, I really wanted there to be some kind of relaxing spots downstairs. So I did really rely on the photographs that I had found because unfortunately, I have never been to Greece or the Greek Isles, so I don't know what they look like in person, and I really did have to get a bit of a list of photos going on, a bit of a collage on my phone, and it was very helpful, you know. And let me know down below in the comments, guys, if this house sort of gives you Greek vibes. Hopefully I was able to portray it a little bit more, but as you guys can tell right now, I did add in a little bit of Greek revival. So the previous houses that I made for this series were very Greek revival, which is more of an American style of housing. While I wanted to try to go for more of the traditional Greek looking house. So that's why from many of the angles of this house, it does look more Greek in my opinion. Fingers crossed, I got it all right. I really, really tried, guys. And that's why it took me so long to build this. So right now we are building something totally random, which has to do with the storyline of the series. So it's not random. It does have a meaning behind it. I just don't want to give away anything to you guys yet, but it is kind of random. It's just this giant excavation of ruins right next to the house. And if you guys don't know much about the Oh My Goddess or Goddess series, basically their father who went missing, he was on a voyage or an expedition. What he was searching for, we do not know just yet, but I definitely think he was a bit of an archaeologist also, and I wanted to give that sense that he had excavated this entire ruins next to their holiday home. And I'm not even sure if their mother would have even known that these ruins were here. So it kind of gives a sense that maybe they bought this holiday home not just to have holidays at. And I'm going to go into further details about this lot and everything probably in the next episode while we are doing the insides of the house, because today we are mainly focusing on the outside. It was a big job because there are so many plants, guys. So many little different areas. Like we have these ruins, and then we have the pool area. We have actually two pool areas, which I tried to connect with that waterfall. I know it doesn't look that great, but I really tried, okay? But yeah, see what I did here with the pavement? I actually really like this. So basically, you just press one of the arrow keys, not the actual like up, down, not those ones. It's the one that has the comma and the full stop. So you have to like, it's those buttons on your keyboard, and it will turn around your floor tile. And I really think it can be super effective in making floor tiles look more imperfect in a good way. It looks so much nicer than just having the tile go all in one direction. So there's just a fun little tip for you guys if you wanna try that out for yourselves. But yeah, now we're going to be chucking in a bunch of trees. There are actually so many trees in this household, and right now you can tell that the roof is actually orange, possibly because I was looking at old photos of the very first house that I had made, probably in like 2015 or something, a very long time ago. I made a really awesome big Greek home. And if you guys know what I'm talking about, let me know down below. But it had these blue window frames with the bright orange roof, and you guys seem to like it at the time. It's just very stark, isn't it? Such a contrast. Sadly, I end up deciding that I don't like the orange and it doesn't match the rest of the island, because I have a whole bunch of other houses on this island in Windenburg, and I wanted them to all sort of match. So that's why right here, you can see I have everything turning to white. I even changed the windows for a while, but I do eventually turn them to a light blue because it makes it look like it's just a faded version of that bright blue. And maybe in the future, you know, the girls could repaint it to a vibrant Aegean, is that how you say that word? Aegean blue. Oh gosh, I'm terrible at pronunciation. Oh man. But if you guys want to know a little bit more about this place, I'm just gonna tell you right up now, it is totally abandoned. That's what I mean by the title, Abandoned Beauty. So it is going to be a little bit difficult to live in for the girls, but that is going to be all a part of the series and the storyline. And I'm kind of excited because it is going to be a challenge, and it's gonna be better than them just living in a big old mansion. So I think it's going to bring a whole new aspect to our series. So I'm really excited for that. I also think that living in a giant mansion has totally been done before in Sim series. So I thought, why not do the total opposite and just live in an abandoned house. So it's going to be kind of fun, and there's definitely a lot of mystery in this house. It's going to be kind of interesting finding out what happened here. And the girls are also going to be trying to figure out their father's mystery and also some things about their parents. So not just their father, also their mother. But again, I really, really do not want to give away too much about this story to you guys. But I just really, really hope that you guys like this different sort of, I guess, aesthetic that we'll be living in a crazy, random, abandoned house, which is just full of secrets, full of clues for the girls to figure out. And there are actually going to be a couple floors that are not accessible. So some rooms they won't be able to get into, and I do leave out creating those rooms because I didn't want you guys to see. I want that to stay a secret, and because while I'm playing the game, I don't want it to accidentally slip. While we are going through the entire series, I will create those rooms. I'm not going to create them right now because what happens if I accidentally go up a room or whatever and then you guys see it? That would just reveal everything, and I kind of want to keep you guys guessing what's going to happen next too. So that is the reason why I'm not going to create them until we get up to those actual episodes. But it's going to be really cool. I'm excited. This is a total different mystery sort of story to Vampires of Nightshade. It's meant to be a bit more to do with family and goddesses, mythology. To go in hand with the mythology, there is going to be some magical aspects to the series. But a lot of it's going to be sort of politics to do with social conventions. There's going to definitely be clubs going on, so popularity contests, stuff like that. So there will be like a superficial side and then a supernatural side. So I'm really keen to kind of explore a mix of both. And it's going to be a little bit sad because the girls are here just trying to find out the truth, and I feel like everyone in the town is going to be sort of semi against them because there's just going to be so much happening. The whole town is going to be shaken up. I don't want to give away too much. But yeah, they definitely do have a dark secret going on, and the girls need to figure it out. It's going to be a very cool mystery, and I'm keen to get into it. But yeah, I really like these gardens that I'm creating. I had so much fun making everything look overgrown and unkept. It just was very cool. It kind of reminded me of my garden at home because my mom used to garden a lot. And then when she stopped gardening, we had all of these bulbs and all of these shrubs and stuff in the garden, which just went wild. They would still flower, they would still flourish each spring, but they were really crazy. Like, they grew giant and they would just overflow out of the gardens. And that's another reason why I thought it was important that I put vines absolutely everywhere. So there are vines probably on every single exterior wall, and when we get into the interior in the next part, we will actually see a lot of plants indoors too, which is going to be really cool because it's gonna feel like the girls are living both indoors and outdoors at the same time. And I know I'm always raving on about how I love to live indoors and outdoors at the same time, but this is actually legit. Like, the house is crumbling, the walls are coming down, and the outside is actually coming into the indoors. So excuse that motorcycle. That is the second time it has gone past today. Jeez. So speaking of bringing the outdoors indoors, now we're going to get into a little bit of fun with one of these rooms. So I thought it would be really cool if we had a tree actually growing in the side of the house. Basically, I want to give the sense that this house has been abandoned for possibly 10 to 15 years. So pretty crazy, right? And I have to be honest, this was a little bit tricky. It took me a couple tries to get it right, but I'm really happy with how it ends up looking. And it was very fiddly, but after I finished working out how to make this tree work, I did learn how to do other little holes in the ceiling for other areas of the house. So it was all worth it. I wasn't just gonna do this corner. There are holes all over the place in this build, guys. Like, there are literally holes everywhere in the floor, in the ceiling, in the walls. I think it's really cool. And also, I'm not sure if I showed you guys before, but over at the pool, I did replace the top pool. I was having a lot of trouble with that back area, I have to be honest. But I did end up just putting one of the, I think it was the Romantic Garden stuff pack. I put that big sculpture there and I was able to fit the pool around it like a circle so perfectly. And I was really happy with that. It just made it look so pretty and Greek. And I'm so glad that I was able to make the backyard work because, you know, I really liked that angle of the house, but it was also very hard to landscape around. So that really did help that I was able to do that. And you guys are probably going to see that I do work in sections. So when I don't have an idea for a certain area, I will go and move to another side of the house. So it was very, very monotonous doing all of these vines over and over again. There are just so, so many. It's gonna be funny, like the episodes when we had the girls trying to get rid of them, but honestly, it looks so beautiful. I kind of don't want to get rid of them. They're just so pretty, but I don't know. We're gonna have to fix it up a little bit eventually, aren't we? We can't just have the house falling apart for the entire series, but it definitely is quite gorgeous for an abandoned house. Like, they are meant to be in a place that kind of looks like the Greek Isles. I haven't been there myself, but I'm not sure if it's meant to be lush, but here on this island, I am making all of the houses be prone to earthquakes, and they are also meant to be very lush places. So that's why I wanted to give the impression that everything was growing. It was just going wild. Like, it just kept raining and raining and things just kept growing. So I really hope that I gave that impression well. I added so many plants, and I know sometimes you guys already get annoyed at me playing around with too many plants in my builds, but this time it's on purpose. It's to make it look abandoned, all right? So don't yell at me, please. But yeah, I love the back area so, so much. It really did come together, didn't it? So I am going to drop one more hint about the series. So basically, the girls are going to have no money to their name or next to no money. So it's going to be very difficult for them to maintain this house. They're going to be living in something that is almost unlivable, and they're going to have to get jobs. Well, the eldest, Artemis, who is a young adult, she is going to have to get a job and try to support her family. So that's going to be a challenge. And in her spare time, we'll get them trying to fix up the house. So it's going to be a challenge itself. But at the same time, they're going to be getting out there, trying to find clues in the world of Windenburg. And also, while they are cleaning up the house, they will possibly find some more clues hidden around the house. So I'm really excited to get into the interior in the next part, because I'm going to talk a little bit more about the story and about what this house was for, why it was in their family. I don't want to talk about everything in this episode because then I wouldn't have anything to talk about next one. But I am just so glad that I put this much effort into the exterior, because we even have these cracks everywhere and it does really look like it's derelict and it's falling apart. Like, the walls definitely need patching up here and there, and it needs repainting for sure. Everything is just falling apart. And eventually, I am going to be adding in a hole in the roof. I think there's a couple holes in the roof But we might be doing that next episode. I have no idea when I do it. I don't think we do it this part though. I kind of slide that in. I had that idea while I am doing the interior a bit later on. So that probably is next part. But I guess that's all interjoined with the doing the insides of it anyways. But I really liked how I did this, where I put like the chairs around because I did want the house to feel like teenagers had broken in and they had moved things around. So one of those chairs from that dining table did end up at the bottom of the pool because, you know, teenagers do dumb stuff like that sometimes. Well, not necessarily teenagers, but people who break into places like that. So rascals, I don't know what you want to call them, but I thought that was just a funny little thing. And I tried to include a few little details like that in this house. But yeah, I thought it was kind of cool that I replaced these railings with these broken, more ancient looking columns, balustrade, sorry. And it just looks very nice. I like it. I am so happy with these ruins that I created on the side of the house. It actually looks really nice. I was surprised because honestly, it's a giant hole in the ground that's just totally brick and just columns and stuff. I thought it was going to look totally ugly, but it ended up kind of blending in with the rest of the house. And I'm so glad because it's a big part of the story and it's going to be very important later on. So do keep that in mind, guys. I know some of you are probably going to be like, what is this? Tell me more, but I can't tell you guys too much because this is supposed to be a bit of a mystery, so I can't give away anything. I'm so sorry. So if you guys haven't watched the creator sim of the new family that I've made for this series, I'll of course have that as a card for you guys to click on and you guys can watch it after you finish this one. But yes, I explain a little bit more about the characters over there, a little bit of snippets here and there. And I'm just so excited to see them live in this house. I've never played a Sims game before where they've lived in a horrible, horrible abandoned home. But honestly, I can't say that this house is totally horrible. It's quite charming in a way. I was very much inspired by the movie The Secret Garden while creating this. I loved that film and that story when I was young, and I just really wanted to kind of encapsulate that magic in this build. And I really envisioned something that was both angelic but abandoned and magical at the same time. Like, I don't know, sometimes abandoned houses can look beautiful, guys. They don't always have to be scary trap houses or anything like that. So this one is supposed to be more of a friendly one, but I do have to say that while I was making this house, at one point, I did get spooked out. In real life, guys, I got scared and I had to go into my room with my boyfriend. I was like, hug me, please. I don't know why I'm getting scared, but I am. And it was weird, but I am the biggest scaredy cat ever, so that's probably the reason why. But yeah, guys, we are coming up to the end of the first part of the Abandoned Beauty house build. I hope you guys all enjoyed creating the exterior with me today. Tomorrow or the next day, we'll be releasing the interior. But yeah, hope you guys all have a fantastic day. I love you all to bits, and I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.